average day in the life of a peregrine biologist. Usually you're up at daybreak. It can be going from 6 to 8 sites in a day. It can be going up to a nest to work at confirming that the chicks have hatched. Sometimes that can be done remotely with a spawning scope.
I think one of the kind of neat things about the Midwest peregrine falcon population is probably the best studied of any large-scale restoration effort of an endangered species in the world. Primarily because probably about 80% of the adult population has been banded.
People always ask us why we band and why is it so important for us to continue this work even 30 some odd years later. And I think the key is we've just begun to find out information about these individual birds and their relationship to one another, their survivalship, their productivity, their migratory patterns. We have a fairly short window of opportunity where it's safe to band the chicks. So we only have about a 10 to 12 day opportunity for most of our territories, which keeps the banding team pretty active. During banding day, if it requires climbing team, we need climbers that can rappel down to the cliff ledge, gather the chicks up, put them in a small transport box that's safe for the chicks that can then make the ride back up to the top of the cliff to the banding team itself. I put almost 20,000 miles on my car alone, and I work with somebody else that puts easily 15,000 miles to monitor 15 or 20 sites. So it definitely is something you need to be passionate about to get the results that we get. It's all worth it.